Ne on irait là, il n'y a pas de
हेलो, गुड इवनिंग सर। हेलो,
गुड
या वेरी
इवनिंग
गुड
मैम।
इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग गुड इवनिंग मैम।
ओके गुड सर, कुड यू शेयर स्क्रीन शेयर सर।
यस यस नाउ यू कैन यू कैन।
ओके, सो आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन द सेकंड सेशन ऑफ आवर लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म वीकेंड इंस्टीट्यूट। And today our respectable Geeta ma'am is going to teach us new grammar related things. So enjoy today's session. Thank you. And
thank you.
Now then we can continue.
Hello.
Yes ma'am.
Hello. I'm audible. Okay.
Yes ma'am.
Okay.
Yes ma'am, you are.
Good evening all of you. And in this session, I'm going to take a grammar session, and it is about preposition. And all you know that in the grammar part, this preposition, it is a vast syllabus and very confused syllabus. So. And I try my best to make you clear. I don't know how can I do this. Let us start. So I think all of you can see the is it audible screen?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, yeah.
Yeah. So here preposition is there. First of all, we come to know that what is the preposition. Preposition is a word itself. It is placed before a noun or pronoun. That means pre plus position. That means before placed or placed before. And it connects that noun or pronoun with the rest of the sentence and specifies the meaning. That means it gives accuracy to the meaning. So if we want to become a fluency in English, first of all we should know the preposition, because when we master the preposition, then our speaking, so it will be very wonderful. And also it establishes the relationship between two nouns or pronouns. And when I give you example, then I will it will be cleared. So I'll go to next session. For example, here one example is there. Pen is on the table. So here, pen is on the table. Pen is one noun, and the table is another noun. And here I have used on. Suppose if on is not there, then it gives no meaning at all. It has no value. It has no meaning. So the preposition, even though it is a very quiet, a small in size, the preposition, it's a very important, because it shows the position, the pen, the relationship between pen and the table. If there is no word on, then these two nouns, if they are there, but we can't understand the relationship between these two noun. And the same way here, cow is in the garden. Cow is also noun and the garden is also noun, and this in, it connects these two nouns. If there is not a word in, then it has no meaning at all. So the sentences are read without the prepositions. If there is no preposition, the meaning will be vague, or it is what is not intended. So it is a very small. If it is only two letter word, but prepositions are very important and very useful in our grammar. So next we go to next session. And here in this I think you can see one diagram here. Here it is types of preposition. So types of preposition we can see. One is single and double and compound and phrases. So according to their usage, we can divide it, these preposition into single. So single preposition, it means only two letter word. That means in, on, by. These are single prepositions. Double prepositions. So when two letter word, that means into, onto, within, that means here two prepositions are combined here. So it is called double. And then it is a compound preposition. Compound preposition means there is a mixture of two prepositions, that means beneath and between and so above, under. So all these comes under compound preposition. And phrases, you know that the phrases, it's a very difficult task and very confusing. And phrases and prepositions, when preposition is added to a verb, it verbal preposition, and so there are many prepositions are there. So it is about types of preposition. And next we go to the same kind. So I have written here the same diagram. I have written here on the basis of size or composition, there are four types of prepositions: simple prepositions, double prepositions, compound prepositions. See here, compound prepositions: beneath, between, below. So here, compound by plus twain, between, by plus neath, beneath, by plus low, below. And here this, there is a there are two types of words, but it gives another word, so it is compound preposition. And there is a phrasal prepositions are there. And now we move to the next. And so here in this slide, I am going to describe about on the basis of the use of categories, prepositions are prepositions of time, prepositions of place, manner, movement, and all these types are there. So in a case of these prepositions, the types are not important, their proper usage is the matter of concern. Let us study the prominent prepositions with their use in sentences. So I go to the next slide. And here in the preposition, and some prepositions are fixed preposition. Already I told you the preposition is a very confusing grammar, but sometimes these are fixed. That means there is no confusion and it is always fixed preposition. So first take a look the preposition in. And here I am taking the preposition in a preposition of time. And where this in is used, and it is used, you can see the screen. In is used before all the months. It is always fixed. In August, in April, in May. So before all the months, we have to use in. And all the before all the seasons, in summer, in winter, in rainy season. And before parts of the day, in the morning, in the evening, but there's an exception. And we always use at before night. It is one exception. And before the years, in 2008, in 1999, and it is used in an or, and in the kitchen, in the car, in the picture. So all these nouns, before these nouns, we always use in. And next we go to on. And these are all prepositions of time. Prepositions, no, prepositions, sometimes it is time and sometimes it's a place also. So on is always used. You know, on, it is surface. That means it's always in touch. On the desk, on the table, that means on the surface of the area. On the wall, on the left side, on the front side, on the way, on leave, on the phone, on TV, on the internet, on Monday, on Friday, on Sunday. So in this way, it is on is used. And next, we go to the next one. It is at. And so at is used, and it, here it, I have taken at prepositions of a place, at the corner, at the bus stop, at the door, at the top of the page, at the end of the road, at the entrance, at the crossroads, at the front desk. So all these nouns we use at. And I think these are all the commonly we are using it, and then specification is there. So I think all this is these are all clear. So now here one small test is there. Hello. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. Everyone is there, no? Okay.
Yes.
So yeah, yeah. There is one test, and so you have to fill these blanks, okay? One by one, you have to do it. I think you can read this. Don't call me dash lunchtime. You should come time.
Is it we at?
Yeah, here.
Yeah, at lunchtime.
No, it is here, it should be there. Huh? Okay. Not here, huh? Some small mistake, yes, is there. Yeah, here. Could you come and all these things? So, can you, one by one, can you do this? And first one we will do. It's very easy.
Yeah, first one will be at.
Yeah, first one will be at. Yes, correct. And
on.
And the third one was
also on.
On Monday. Also on Monday.
Yeah. And here I'm going to do the presentation at the company.
In the next week. In the next week.
The is missing, I think.
In the next week. Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And they are getting married
within two months.
In two months. This beautiful building was built
built in
the 16th century.
Oh, 16th. Sorry. I thought date. No.
In the 16th century.
Ah, yeah. Yes. Right, ma'am. I thought date.
If there is no.
John is away on holiday.
At the moment.
I have got 2 days off.
On Easter. On
Easter.
On Easter.
No, no.
Yeah,
in Easter.
At Easter.
Okay.
At.
On the wall.
The picture is
on the wall.
On the wall.
The Jane is
at the bus stop.
At the bus stop.
Yes. Okay.
Ma'am, I have a question that. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, ma'am. This is Subhashree. So ma'am, you used that beneath. What does it mean?
Beneath means, so it is under. Mm-hmm. Beneath means is under. But there is a slight difference between under and beneath. So when I take that session, then I will make it clear. Okay, beneath means under. Beneath, below, under, all
yeah,
these
below, beneath. Yeah, below, beneath and under. These are the same sound, same word.
But there is slight difference is there. Then in the same way, above, over, on. These are all on the surface, but there is slight difference.
Okay.
In the same way, under, beneath, and below, these have also a slight difference is there. Okay?
Okay.
So these are the answer. And now I have some, the same thing. I have some examples here, some simple prepositions. She looked at the stranger, and by he was helped by his uncle, and with uncle helped him with the money, and for the baby asked for its mother, and from she comes from a remote village. Money is in the purse, the book is on the table. And of, I forgot the names of my students. Of, the water is flowing off the wells and ponds. Out, she jumped out of the window, and through, the telephone cable is brought through a steel pipe. These are all common nouns. And then, and some more examples I have taken here. Till, I will stay here till 1 o'clock, until they were in a quarantine, until their complete recovery. She went to temple, and we climbed up the hill tirelessly. Over, the fan is moving over my head, and upon, he rode upon his bullet. After, she came after me, under, a cow is resting under the tree. And then again some more examples there. And above, it's a compound prepositions. Above, the water came above their knees. So here I have some pictures also there. And about, she asked about the fee structure. Across, a bridge is built across the river Gangavali. Along, the trekkers went along a trodden path. And here I have written the meaning also. That means where it's above is used. Above, it means it is in extended space over and not touching. If it is touch is there, then we use on. But above, and it is in extended space. About, you know, she asked about the, that means on the subject of. Across. Across means, so here I have shown on picture, it is called across. A bridge is built across the river Gangavali. That means from one side to the other of. And along. So along means moving in a constant direction on more or less horizontal surface. It is called along. So I think all these are clear. And so I shall move to the next one. And here also some examples are there. Amidst, the politicians are busy slinging mud at each other even amidst COVID crisis. Among, there is a sweet bond among the members of that family. Amongst, my son was one amongst the team selected for quiz. Around, there is a beautiful garden around my house. So these are all examples for these prepositions. And so I think so over. Yeah. So I don't know. I have done many videos, but I don't know. Okay. So these are about some prepositions, and when, tomorrow also I'm taking the same prepositions and some prepositions I will take tomorrow. Thank you. Hello.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
It was a wonderful session, wonderful teaching. We learned about preposition. So now I would like to ask to Prakash sir, sir, what are we going to do?
Ma'am, Sanjeev here. One doubt in preposition.
Okay, sir, tell me.
So when can we use on to? Do you have any example on to?
Yes, sir. On to, sir, when a thing is moving to upwards, on to. So when it is moving, it is used for when action is moving, sir. On that case, it is using. If I can give example, so I where it's
like ma'am, cat jumps onto the table.
Onto, yes, moving upward direction, and it is in that moment we use onto.
Okay, then I am she climbed on the roof.
She climbed. When it is climb means it's up.
Yeah, climb means I am going upwards.
The aeroplane going. So, ma'am, we are going to onto the bridge.
What, sir?
Means we are going on to the bridge. We are going on to the bridge.
On to the bridge. We are going, that means we are walking. Walking, okay. No? Walking session. So, it is.
It will be right or wrong?
No, we are.
Means bridge is not
across. Sir. Hello?
Means, ma'am, bridge is not level. Yeah.
Huh?
It's means up or down, means like that bridge.
Sir, which preposition you want to use that? What's your question?
Yeah, ma'am.
Tell me the sentence.
Means Rohit Dhake sir asking for on to example, so that's why.
On to.
So that is correct, ma'am, or
which one?
Yeah, ma'am. We are going on to the bridge.
Yes.
We are going on to the bridge.
Yeah.
Ma'am, I have an example.
No. It is not. It's not that way, sir.
I think on to use when something is movement. Something
moving. Yeah, something is moving from
one to another
downwards
place.
To upwards. Yes.
Ma'am, can I give a an example?
Okay. Give.
I climbed a ladder to get onto the roof.
Okay. Onto the roof.
Okay, so the monkey is climbing onto the tree.
Climbing onto the tree.
Yes, ma'am.
Climbing up the trees. Idu. Climbing up.
Okay.
Then how could we say that it is off to it upward movement?
Yes.
Means our car is going to upward in the hill. So that time we can use the on to, ma'am.
No. I do one thing. So it is today. I have taken only this session. No, tomorrow I will make it clear on to and into and all these things. I will take tomorrow. Okay.
Okay.
Ma'am. I think on okay. and on to is meaning is same, but you know if it moves, it not.
It is movement. Right. It's movement.
It is a movement. But meaning moment, is on moment. And yes, on and onto meaning is same, I think.
Yeah. It's upward movement. Yes. Into means so see some like when it, into is there from outside to in. In the same way, yes, it's yes, on yes. To,
same way.
Yeah. Upward movement.
Yes.
And anyone wants to give some example using all these can you give some examples using in
water in the well? Yes.
Ma'am, it is correct. Like children are playing onto the roof.
Children are playing onto the roof.
Yeah.
No. Children are playing on the roof. Oh, it's okay on the roof, but it is not a sense. It is not giving meaning. Is not there because on the roof it is not. But if you use on, then it's okay.
Ma'am, I want to give one example.
Okay.
Ma'am, can I give one example? On the way. Now I am going on the way to my office.
Yeah. Okay. It's clear, sir.
Yeah. There is a beautiful picture on the wall.
On the wall. Yes.
Yeah.
And today I am on leave.
Yes.
I am talking on the phone. I am using.
I am on the internet.
On the front side of my
on the internet.
Yeah.
On the front side of my house, there is a beautiful garden.
Garden. Okay.
IPL match is broadcasting on the Hotstar.
On the TV.
Yeah.
My mobile is right now on the desk.
Desk, yes, okay. And in?
I'll reach the destination in an hour.
Reaching destination?
I'll reach my destination in an hour.
In an hour, yes, okay, sir.
Yeah.
The weather is very hot in the summer.
Yeah, sir.
I want to say something.
Okay.
Yeah, I watched Prakash sir video in the morning. It was very interesting.
In the morning, yes.
It was very interesting, yeah.
I had received a gift from Prakash sir in the afternoon.
in the no afternoon it's not using.
Okay. At afternoon.
Use the afternoon.
Yeah. At afternoon.
In the afternoon, at night, in the morning, in the afternoon.
No, sorry, sir. Night. At afternoon.
At afternoon.
Yeah, yeah.
Night.
Oh.
No. Yeah, yeah.
No, in the afternoon. But afternoons, no, we use in the afternoon.
I have Cambridge grammar.
Yes, in the afternoon we use in the afternoon.
I put sanitizer in the car.
In the car. Yes, okay.
In the morning, I was in the kitchen.
Yeah.
In the morning, Isa ma'am called me.
In the kitchen.
Okay. May I, ma'am?
Ha, okay.
In my house, there are lots of... in my house, there are lots of Lord Krishna pictures.
In my house?
There are lots of Lord Krishna's pictures.
Yeah, okay. And at?
I was waiting at the bus stop for about half an hour.
Yeah. Yeah, okay.
There is some symbol at the top of the page.
Yes. There's a dog at the corner.
At 9 p.m. at night. Every day we meet there, at 9 p.m. at night. Is it
there is some. Yeah, there is someone knocking at the door.
At the door, yes. Someone knocking at the door.
At the entrance of my house, there is a beautiful pot.
Pot, yes. Okay.
I used to go to drink coffee at the end of the road.
Yeah.
I crossed at the crossroads.
At the bus stop.
I saw a picture at the top of the page.
PLR connected.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, yes.
Yes, 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 ma'am.
Yeah. Actually, I have some other videos also, but I don't know where I kept it. Okay, let it be. Okay, thank you. So, I think I have done with it.
Hello.
Thank you so much.
Hello,
ma'am.
Okay.
Yeah, now
hello.
Prakash sir, you will handle. Yeah.
So, what is it? It is wrong? In the afternoon is wrong, madam?
No, not wrong, sir. It is correct, sir.
It's correct. It is correct, sir. Correct. In the afternoon, yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, correct, sir.
At noon and in the afternoon.
Yeah. Because I have studied from Cambridge in the morning, in the afternoon, at night.
At noon, in the afternoon.
At noon, at night.
Yes. At noon and at night. But in the afternoon.
Yeah, in the afternoon.
Yeah, in the afternoon. Yes, sir.
Okay.
I met him in the afternoon.
Yeah.
This is like that.
So how much time we have left?
4 minutes.
4 minutes, yeah.
3 minutes.
Yeah, so Pabya, you can invite one by one for feedback speech, okay?
Okay, sir. Can we select our today's participants?
Yeah, you can.
Ma'am, please stop your screen sharing.
Okay, so we have only 3 minutes left, so...
Actually, Shrivani is not here, but I have already selected
her. Shrivani is there.
Now she is here.
Yes, yes. Shivani, hello.
Yeah.
Shivani is here.
So, Shivani, will you participate tomorrow? Are you ready?
Yes, sir. Yes, yes, sir. I will participate for current affairs.
Yeah. So we need one more participant, sir. So, Pankaj sir, would you like to perform on current affairs tomorrow?
Yes, yes, sure.
So no problem, sir. We have two participants.
And who is our anchor for tomorrow?
Sir, it's Ranjana, sir. She is not here, but she told that she will do that.
Okay. Sir, on Monday,
inform her.
Monday, yes, Rita, madam from Nepal, she will talk about Nepal or whatever she wants to speak, okay? And okay, also, you can invite Anusuya, yeah. Anusuya, madam, okay. Are you ready for Monday to say something?
Okay, sir. Because I don't know how to prepare the slide, I have only mobile phone, therefore I am waiting in Saturday, Sunday, only my husband... holidays, then only I ask him to some ideas. How can I prepare the slides?
So you have enough time. Therefore, okay, you have to perform on Monday. You have enough time for that.
Okay, okay, sir. I will do. Okay, sir. I will do, sir.
Okay. And Rita, madam, are you ready for Monday or not?
Ready, sir.
Okay, that's all.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah, yeah. So we all are looking forward to listening to you, okay, on Monday.
Sir, one thing. So tomorrow I will take a grammar session. Then after that, Monday onwards, what about this grammar session? Okay.
I will take one class.
Okay.
Monday you will take, no?
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Okay.
Prakash, I want to take class. Grammar class.
Okay, sir. Okay, Monday okay. Means Tuesday? And, Tuesday.
Monday. Tuesday you can take.
Okay,
thank you. Yes, sir.
And for Monday, I will be the anchor. For
Monday, you will be an anchor. Then who will be an anchor? Okay, yeah, Ranjana Goswami is an anchor. Okay. So, Rohit, Mr. Rohit wants to be an anchor on Monday. That's your clear for you, Papya?
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, thank sir. You. Thank you, Papya. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So just Papya, feedback speech for Jaya madam. Really, I enjoyed a lot today. She worked.